I'm so very glad to see you all again. So I know I should probably be doing another Valentine's Day balloon because it's tomorrow, but I really didn't think you'd get much use out of it since it's tomorrow, and there's something else coming out that's so close that I think is gonna be, it's just gonna work out so much better for you guys, and for you, if, you know, if this is a business for you, it's gonna be a lot more helpful. So I figured today we'd make Sonic! Now for Sonic, I use four balloons, like four 260s, scrap white, and then like a tiny scrap black, and sometimes a round. It's not necessary, but sometimes it just makes it, give it that little extra pop. To start, I always start with my blush, and I usually have about four fingers at the end. Now to start, I do a three-finger flower petal, so about three fingers, and wrap that in. And then I will do another three-finger flower petal right here, just like that. So the rubber's about the same size. So these are going to be the two cheeks, and then we're going to do the same thing but for his nose. So another three-finger flower petal, three fingers, and wrap those in together. So now we have two cheeks and a nose. And it should look a lot like a clover here. Now, for me, what I like to do is I like to put a little pinch twist here just because it holds everything together better. So just a little pinch twist right there. Pinch twist, clover, and then you can remove the rest of this. Try to save some though, because we'll use that later. Tie that off. And then for this part, we only need a four-finger bubble. So at four fingers, that's it. Tie that off, and then we'll put this away for later. Then we're gonna go to our scrap white. You don't really need much, you just need it to be about eight fingers. So we're gonna take the scrap white, and we're gonna like just twist it into that clover though. Perfect. Just like that. And then we're gonna do about four finger bubble here. And then we're gonna do another four finger bubble down and into that pinch twist at the bottom. And then we can just get rid of the rest of it. Don't need it. And then you have Sonic's cheeks, his nose, and his eyes. And he's coming out mauve this year. Then we're gonna move on to the blue balloon, because Sonic's blue, and they're all gonna be about four fingers at the end. So there's three blue balloons, all about four fingers at the end. Same size, making things easy. So we're gonna take this, and we're gonna wrap this into this flower, that clover. Now what I like to do, just for measurements, I like to take this, pull it up and over those eyes, so like it goes through the middle, goes through the middle there, so you can see eyes on either side, and up and over, and then I like to sort of measure by sight here, so I want the pinch, we're going to do a pinch twist, and I want it to be just below when it comes around that end, so about there, and just for reference sake, that ends up being about 10 finger bubble, and then we can put a pinch twist here, just like that. So once we get that 10 finger bubble done, that pinch twist done, we can bring it around, and then we'll do about a 3 finger bubble and wrap that into those cheeks. So we'll have a 10 finger bubble, and then a pinch twist, and then a 3 finger bubble that goes back down into the cheeks. So it should look like this. Perfect. So, and then we're going to do about 5-finger bubble, and we're going to wrap that up and into that pinch twist. And then we're going to do another 5-finger bubble, and we're going to bring it back down and into those cheeks, just like that. So then we should have that front loop, well, that front one that goes over the eyes, and then three bubbles at the back. to that pink Swiss of chocolate. And then that will give Sonic's first bite. I like to take this off just so it's easier to do the last flower petal out of this bowl. So we have it, like I'm just holding it here. I've let some air out. And then this should be able to turn into a three-finger flower petal. Put that off and then wrap it into the pinch twist and just tie it off. And then this will be one of his ears. So then we're going to take our second blue balloon, again, four fingers on the end. We're going to wrap it into his cheek. Just like that. And then here we're going to do a three finger bubble, and then another 8-finger bubble. And then we're going to take this up and wrap it into that ear and top pinch twist. And then we're going to do another ear. So we're going to do another 3-finger flower petal. Flower petal, make sure it's 3 fingers. Twist them together and wrap that around the pinch twist. Then we're going to do an 8-finger bubble. Then a 3-finger bubble. And then bring it down the other side and wrap that into his cheek. So we're going to bring it down the other side and wrap it into his cheek. So just like this. Okay, so with Sonic, there's two ways of thinking. Some think that he's got like a big bushel of spikes on his back, and something that he doesn't, and it's just like straight down kind of deal. Now really this is just like mostly a generational thing, which generation of Sonic you've seen the most. So what you can do is you can, if you want it to be like straight down the back, if that's what the kids you're dealing with know, you can push those spikes in the back and he'll look like that version. Now, if the kids you know think he's got like the big bushiness of spikes, what you do is you pull this out, and this is kind of why we have the ears placed where they are, and then we put those extra bubbles in the back of his head. So you pull those bubbles out, and then it'll create those spikes. So what'll happen is he'll get these bigger spikes on the side. But again, if it's the other ones, you can push it back, and then he's got less spikes that you can see from the front. This is the way my 9-year-old son likes it, mostly. And then I find that older generations like it where it comes out more. And if it's not out enough, you can always change these 3-finger bubbles to another size, 5-finger bubbles. And you can just do that like from here. So twist it like that, and that seems to make them happier. We're gonna do what the kid likes though, just cause, you know, we're here for the kids. So that's gonna be pretty much his head. I'm gonna put this aside for a second and we'll do the details on it later. So we're gonna go for the other blue balloon, again, 4 fingers. And this, if you've seen the Cupid one, the body is very similar. So we're gonna start with 2 pinch twists. Just lock that one in. And then a 4-finger bubble. And then 2 pinch twists. And then we're gonna do a 4-finger bubble. And then a 4-finger bubble down. So you got like a sausage link here. And then we're gonna pull this back up, twist those together. And just to lock it in, we're gonna take this balloon and move it through the center of the leg. Really like that. Then we're going to come back up, wrap it around those top pinch twists. We're going to do a 4-finger bubble, and then 2 pinch twists here. Just like that. have that blush, we're going to use this for the belly. So we're going to wrap that into the top two pieces and bring it down and wrap it around the waist and just lock it in. I like to just push it into the back. Take that head, maybe the tiniest little bubble to the neck, and just wrap that into a composition. And then you can get rid of this. Perfect. If you really want to use that brown that we were talking about earlier, I like to use a red brown, and I'll just twist it in the middle here. So make sure the knot is by your finger or your thumb. Twist them in half so they're about even. That's not even at all. Another reason you want to make sure the knot is in the middle, or you'll get wonky ones. And then you want to take half of it and push it through the middle of his leg. And then you have quick and easy feet. Or feet. Yes. And the last scrap that we were talking about was the black. It's just the very end, very small. So like, it's very small. Then I take it, I'm not sure how well you can see this here. So the flower petal on his nose is right here. So I like to push it into that flower petal. Pull it all the way through. Then we'll take this and we'll wrap it around his cheek, just so it stays in place. So then we have his nose. And the last detail is just his artwork. So his eyes, drawn, are actually pretty simple. So it's just a big oval with a little circle here. Now, you want, you can always go back over that with an edding if you just want to fill it all in anyways. And fill that in. And then again, just an oval with a circle at the top. And then fill in the rest. And then you have a little Sonic. This is like 13 minutes to make it super slow, like, you know, teaching speed. So it would be a really good design for like birthday parties or restaurant work. It's actually a lot quicker when you're on the job. So I hope you guys like this one. Leave a comment if you do. And if you've made it this far and you haven't subscribed, why not? Cause you know, we're teaching stuff like this. So I hope to see you guys next Thursday. I'm trying to post every Thursday now. So yeah, if you're back next Thursday, I'm super happy. Thanks guys. Bye. We'll be right back.